flying Mono Vision 12, your pilot of the virtual skies. Today we are flying an Emirates 777-300ER with GE90 engines. As you can tell, I've got everything all set up. We don't have jet bridges on this gate. We are doing a reposition flight from Tampa to Orlando. So it's going to be kind of an oddball flight here. This flight was actually requested by my wife, who wanted to see a 777 go from Tampa to Orlando. So let's get started on this. See the beautiful engines right there, the wing view. This aircraft does have boarding music and all kinds of cool features on it. So I'm going to go ahead and get all that stuff pulled up. Now we're down the outside views, so we pull back up the GPS. Also this room. Yeah, I think that one behind us is perfect. Okay. So, let's just pull everything back up here. View, instrument panel, GPS, view, instrument panel, cabin announcements, view, instrument panel, ground handling. Okay, so we're gonna push back in that direction. Okay. It shows you up in the top right of the ground handling there. You can see everything is green. All those bars, it means the parking brakes are set. You can see on the flight deck panel there that has the safety briefing and everything for the cabin announcements. It's also got the ambient noises, such as the music in the cabin. It's got the gate music, or the gate sounds. Passengers boarding and all that cool stuff, so it just kind of makes it a little more realistic. So right now our beacon is off, our engines are running, that's just how FSX has it, and I didn't want to shut them down and start them back up, so yeah, let's go and get started. I've already got the autopilot set up. We're going to 15,000 feet, heading at 255, and we're going to be flying at 200 knots. We're not going very far, so we're only going to 15,000 feet. Not even high enough to call it a flight level. Let's see. Go ahead and turn on our nav lights, which will also turn on our cabin lights. Makes it a little bit easier to see, even though it is daytime. So let's go ahead and start our pushback. So all we do is make sure your brakes are set when you have one of these panels. I think you can download these places. I don't know. This one came with the airplane. It comes with several of them that I have. But I think you can probably find these and download them. I want to try to get them for all of my aircraft because it makes it so much easier, because you can push back in the direction you want. You don't have to use Shift-P all the time. And you don't have to try to turn yourself around and everything. So let's go ahead and turn off the boarding music and all of that. And we'll go ahead and turn on the safety video. Push us back to the full 15 feet and then turn us 90 degrees. That's what I love about this little system here. I wish I could take this down. I can't see out that window. Probably scoot forward a little bit. There we go. cockpit. All right. And then once they get us pushed back, we'll have to be ready on the brakes. Oh, I forgot to turn the beacon on. Whoops. Okay. Right now, we would normally start firing up number one and all that. You can see they're turning us right now. Here we go. Awesome. Probably didn't need the full 90 degrees, but that's okay. Yeah, 90 degrees is probably a bit too much. Alright, that's good. Alright, so good. There we go, parking brakes set. Now we go ahead and wait for the pin. Alright. Tug is gone. We can go ahead and get rid of this panel. This window. So there goes the tug. Give them a quick wave. Alright, safety video is going. So we're going to go ahead and actually just move this on up and out of the way. And we're going to go ahead and do our quick surface check, so let me, I don't think I can change these screens. Let's go ahead and do a quick surface check. Rudders. Alright, we are good. Go ahead and check the spoilers. Perfect. Got set flaps. Got them set. 10 degrees. It is a pretty short runway. So, alright, let's go ahead and turn on our taxi light. There we go. And let's brakes off, get taxiing out. This one does have, you can hear the brakes whenever you click on the brakes. I am using a joystick in a Boeing. I know it's probably a sin in every way, but eventually I'll get a yoke. Alright, this is a 777-300, so we do have to make this a wide turn. And this thing, unlike other aircraft on FSX, this thing turns on a dime, which is amazing. Usually you can't turn completely, like you can't turn it hard, otherwise it'll just like slip the nose wheel. This one you can, and it turns amazingly. I love this model, but the thing is, it's so detailed it really bogged down my computer. But I just love the fact that it is so detailed. I hear the cabin announcements going, so we're gonna go ahead and let them know we are about to take off. The painted lines were just hideous. It was awful. hopefully it'll turn out a lot better, and hopefully it'll be more enjoyable for you guys and for me and for anyone else that really likes to look at the airport. So hopefully you guys enjoy that. So we're almost to the runway. That's going to be another no ATC flight. When I get back from the trip, I'm going to try to do some stuff on that sim. I really haven't done anything with ATC on that sim. Just some flying around with Caleb. So, I'm mic shy. I need to get used to the mic. Even in real life, flying an airplane, I hate talking. Got 50 hours in the 172. I need to get back. I need to, freaking talk on the radio. Yeah, so we are on the runway here. Let me lower myself down. Oh, too high. Down. You can see over the room. Okay. Perfect. A bit too high in the cockpit. So get myself straightened out here. So we will hold shore of the ILS here. I don't see anyone coming. Go ahead and turn that off. So let's go ahead. I'm actually going to move this out of my window. And we're going to go ahead and start rolling. back on, let go of the joystick. Go ahead and get the send.
This is your captain speaking.
actually had that happen one time. We're noticing at a DFW on an MD-80. And they made the announcement that we're beginning our descent. And look out the window, and we're over DFW Airport on downwind. Somebody was in the bathroom on final, they couldn't get the person out. It was actually kind of funny. Final approach, and they, like, short final, almost about to touch down, and they finally come out of the bathroom. That passenger got a stern talking to. Alright, so hopefully people are vacating the bathroom. Blue. So, checklist, I don't have my checklist on me. I do have a 777 checklist, though. You can print them off online, they're easy to find. You can go to various sim websites, and I just look up Google 777 checklist. Sometimes they're accurate, sometimes they're not. I just find the ones that are most accurate. We'll go ahead and start our descent, and like I said, we're going to manually do that. Just go pull the throttle completely out. Down to 7,000 feet. You know, if I go ahead and go full spoilers. See, beacons on, nav lights are on, taxi lights still on, landing lights are on. Let's go. Alright. We're getting down to 7,000 feet, and then we'll begin a downwind. Airport up in the distance there. reason we have flames coming out of the engines, so we're gonna have to do a stop on the runway. It'd be cool if you could request emergency services on flight 7. Executive. lost my bearings here.
2500.
I don't want to hear that sound yet. Let's go to 80 seconds. I want to see that landing. Far enough back, that's plenty far. Alright.
500. 400.
I'm curious if I struck the tail or not.
300.
You can see the engines burning.
200. 100. 50. 40.
Oh,
40.
Building.
30. 30, 20, 10.
I'd land all three. Oh, nope. Actually, wasn't bad. I call that good. Watch from this point of view, too. Might as well. Instant replay, let's go and go to 60 seconds. Watch it from the passenger perspective.
50. 40. 40. 30. 30. 20. 20. 10.
And if you're sitting next to me on the plane, you will hear the callouts, because I will be saying them. I'll be guessing, but I'll still be saying them. I'd give that about a C plus, B minus. Go back to the cockpit. Escape the pause. Alright. I would say that was a good landing. So we'll go ahead and go back to our cabin announcements. Yeah. parking brake and we'll shut down number two. Control J. Nope, brakes don't move. This one. Okay. Brakes don't move, we'll go ahead and shut down number one as well. Alright, number one is off. Fun little adventure with the 777-300 with the, I guess, the max autopilot. So, yeah, well, stay tuned for more videos, especially airport updates now that I've got, you can see the flame, the smoke's just rolling around the tail. Stay tuned for more airport updates and stuff now that I've got, airport starting to take form and everything. The ramp and everything's coming together pretty well, so we'll be doing a lot more flight sim videos. Hopefully I'm going to get flight sim 2020 again once I get my computer upgraded. Thank you again for joining me. Hope you enjoyed. And remember, as always, geek out, aviators. Bye-bye.
If something matters to you, it still matters at 35,000 feet. So be good to yourself. Fly Emirates.